Okay, so good morning students, and welcome to the another lecture for these engineering graphics. In the last lecture we have seen the construction methods for ellipse, parabola and hyperbola. Okay, so we have seen the two methods, so that is the focus directrix method and the rectangle method. Okay, so focus directrix method is for the ellipse, parabola and hyperbola, while the rectangle method is only for the ellipse and the parabola. Okay, so that we have done. Okay, now the next topic is the cycloid. Okay, so we will see what is meant by the cycloid. Now if you see the definition of the cycloid, so cycloid is a curve, okay, traced by a point on the circumference of a circle. Okay, that means suppose if you have one, this is suppose if we have the wheel, okay, if we have the wheel, and then if you take any point on this wheel, okay, if you mark any point on this wheel, and if this wheel is rotating, if this wheel is rotating, okay, in the forward direction, so along with the wheel this point will also move. Okay, this point will also move, and when see, if you see here, so if this wheel is rotating and this is our fixed point. Now when the wheel is rotating, so then it traces one curve. Okay, so this curve is called as the cycloid. Okay, this curve is called as what, the cycloid. Okay, now how much distance, so this rotating circle, it is called as what, it is called as the generating circle. Okay, so these names you have to remember, or this is also called as the rolling circle. It is rolling, so that's why it is called as the rolling circle. Why it is called as the generating circle? Because it is generating our curve, that is called as the cycloid. Okay, now suppose in one, if we see decide that the wheel is rotating one rotation, means what, the P point will again come to its original position. Okay, now if you see here the P point, that means the P point start from here. Okay, and then the P point again comes on the ground. Okay, so this distance is called as what, this distance is called as the one rotation of the circle. So if you see here, see this point is completing one rotation. Total angle is how much? This is 360 degree. Okay, it total complete the 360 degree, and then again it comes to its original position. Now what is the how much distance it will cover in one rotation? So we know that the distance covered by the circle when it is completing the one rotation, so that is equal to the circumference of the circle. So that distance is equal to what, 2 pi r, or it is pi d. Okay, so this is the pi d. So when one rotation, the circle complete the circle completes how much distance? Pi d distance. So this pi d distance is important for us, and this the circle diameter is important for us. Okay, so two things are there given in the problem. The one is what, the diameter of the circle is given, and then only the diameter of the circle is given in the problem, and we have to construct the cycloid. Okay, so let us take, now see what is the procedure for constructing this cycloid. Now so we will see, so I will show you here, I will construct that one. Now let us take, okay, so let us take the diameter of the circle, so that is equal to, I will take some radius. Suppose I am taking, this is okay, so I am taking 1.5. okay, so I am taking this is equal to the 1.5. okay, so 1.5 we will take, so that is I am taking the radius. Okay, so construct the circle of this much radius. Okay, so here the circle will come somewhat here. Okay, so this is the circle, so radius is of 1.5. okay, so I am now here, you have to construct this with the different lines. Okay, so I am taking here some paint color. Okay, so like this. Now we have to draw here two diameters. After that, after constructing the circle, you construct here the two diameters. Okay, so construction is faint. Okay, in initial circle also we have to construct the with faint lines. Then after that you draw here one vertical diameter. Okay, so two diameters we have drawn. After that, now I want to divide the circles into the 8 parts only. Okay, we have seen how to divide the circles into 12 parts and 8 parts in the previous videos. Okay, so to divide the circle into 8 parts, it is very easy. So what you have to do, you have to take the protractor and just take the 45 degree angle. Okay, so 45 degree angle here, so this is 40, this is 45 here on this side, and the 45 degree angle is on this side. So if you take 45 degree angle, so the circle will get divided into the 8 parts. Okay, So likewise, now we have to, okay, so with this skill it is somewhat, okay, so this is 45 degree angle here, and the, on the another side also we have to join that 45 degree angle line. Okay, so it will come something like this. Okay, now if you check, so the circle get divided into now the 8 parts. Okay, so circle get divided into the 8 parts now. Okay, so what we have done, we have just taken 45 degree angle and we have divided circle into 8 parts. Now, so now I will take here point P. Okay, so the point P is here. Okay, now we will imagine, or we will imagine that the wheel is rotating in clockwise direction. It is rotating in clockwise direction. So after that, what will happen when the wheel start rotating? This P point will come here. So we will name this as a 1. Okay, then it will come here. It will cover 2 divisions. Then it will cover 3 divisions. Then it will cover then 4 divisions. Then 5 divisions. Okay. Then 6 division here, 7 division here, and after that it will come to its original position. Okay, so in the direction of the rotation of the wheel, we have to name the nomenclature of the wheel. So I have taken the point at the base. Okay, so this is on the ground. P 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Divisions are 8. Okay, so the first step is construct the circle, divide the circle into 8 parts by taking 45 degree angle, and then mark the nomenclature here. Nomenclature means what? Point P, and then it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. Now this is our center C. This is our center C here. Okay. Now the next thing is what? Now what we'll do? Now we will imagine that this circle is rotating for one revolution. This is rotating one revolution. One revolution is what? 360 degree. So how much distance it will cover? It will cover pi d distance, a circumference of the circle. Okay, in one rotation, when the circle rotates one rotation, so the distance covered by the circle is equal to how much? It is pi d. So pi d. So what is the distance? So pi is equal to, that is 3.14. Diameter is equal to how much? We have taken the radius 15. Okay, so diameter is equal to 30. So pi multiplied by 30. So how much it will come? So here this is, if you take here, so this is 3.14 multiplied by diameter. Okay, we have to multiply it by diameter. So this is 30. Sorry. This is 3.14 multiplied by 30. 30. So it is 94.2. This is mm. This is mm. So 9.42 centimeter. Okay. So 9.42 centimeter. So we have to take how much distance? So this is our baseline. So 9.42. So this will come here. So this is 9.42. So I have taken this one. This is what? This is my pi d distance. Okay. This is, that means when the circle rotates, it will cover this much distance. Okay. And then at this point, the point P will come at the bottom. Okay. At on the ground. Okay. Now, the next step is what? So what we have done, we have taken pi d distance, so that is our baseline. On this line, our circle will rotate for one revolution and it will cover that distance. Okay. Now the next is what? Now we have divided the circle into 8 parts. So we have to divide this baseline. Baseline also into 8 number of divisions. Okay. So we have to divide this into 8 number of divisions. So you have to take one inclined line here. Okay. Now use your compass. Okay, so then take some small distance in compass. Okay, you take small distance in compass here. Okay, and then mark it here. So this becomes your, this is your first. Okay, I want here 8 divisions. So 1, and this is 2. Okay, then this is 3. Okay, then this is 4. Then this is 5, then this is 6 here, then this is 7, and this one, last one is, this is 8. Okay, so what I have done, I have taken small distance in compass. From here I have marked here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 divisions. Okay, so this is our last division, this is our 8. Okay, this is 7, this is 6 here, here 5, 4, this is 3, this is 2, and this one is 1. So I want 8 divisions. Why? Because I have divided the circle into 8 number of divisions, so I want to divide this baseline, that is pi d distance, is also into 8 number of divisions. Okay. Now what I have told you, how to what is the next step in the line division method? So you have to join this last point, that is what, the 8 point, that is the last intersection, that is our 8 is there. So you have to join this with the end point of the line. So you have to join it with the end point of the line. You have to use roller scale here. So 8 is joined with the end point of the line. Then you have to rotate. Okay. So you have to roll. You have to roll the scale. Then you have to draw the line from 7. Then you have to draw the line from 6. Okay. Then you have to draw the line from this 5. Okay. Then the line from 4. Okay. You have to roll your roller scale. Okay. Then here this is 4. Then this is 2. Okay. And this one is 1. Okay. Now if you see here, so what we have done, we have transferred all the points from the inclined line on the baseline. Okay, so here what we got here. So we got here, this is, okay, let me take the bracket. This is 1. Okay, this is 2. Okay, this is 3. This is 4. This is 5. This is 6. This is 7. And this one is 8. So see, your baseline is also divided into 8 number of divisions, and your circle is also divided into 8 number of divisions. So this is the basic construction. This is the basic construction. So sir, draw the circle, divide the circle into 8 parts, give the nomenclature like this. It is rotating in clockwise direction. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Total divisions are 8 on the circle. So, and then after that, we have taken one line, baseline. Its distance is equal to pi d distance, circumference of the circle. So that comes out to be 9.42 centimeter. So 9.42 centimeter here. Okay. The distance comes out to be 94.2 mm, 9.42 centimeter. Okay. Then I have divided the line into the 8 number of divisions by taking the line division method. Okay. Now once this is worked, now the next thing is what? Next thing is, you keep your roller scale parallel to the baseline. Keep your roller scale here. Okay, on the baseline, then draw a line. Okay, draw a line passing through 1 and 7. Draw a line passing through 1 and 7. Draw a line passing through this 2 and 6. Okay, 2 and 6. Then draw a line passing through 3 and 5. 3 and 5. And then draw a line passing through this 4. Draw a line passing through this 4. Okay, so you have to draw parallel lines. Okay, here from 1, it will pass through 7. From 2, it will pass through 6. From 3, it will pass through 5. And from 4, it will pass from 4, it is a parallel line. Okay, after this, now once these parallel lines are over, now you transfer the, now you transfer here. Okay, you transfer the divisions on the line. These are the divisions on the line. These are the divisions on the line. This becomes our centers. So you transfer these divisions here. Okay. So this will come here. So the divisions will come here. So this is the 1. Okay. Then you have to transfer these 2. So this 2 will come here. Then you have to transfer these 3. So these 3 will come here. You have to transfer this 4 on the center line. So this 4 will come here. Then you have to transfer this 5. So the 5 will come on the center line. Then this 6, you have to transfer on the center line. Then this is 7, you have to transfer it on center line. And the last division is 8. You have to transfer it on the center line. Okay, so this is 8. So what we have done, we are transferring the divisions. So this is 2. This is not, it has not come. So this is 2 and this is 1 here. Okay, this is 1 here. So I have transferred what? I have transferred these 8 divisions from the line to the center line. Okay, so what we got here? So we got here, this is the initial center. This is our initial center. Now this becomes our center number 1. Okay, this is our C2. Okay, this is our C3. Then this is our C4. this is our C5, okay, this is our C6, this is our C7, okay, and the last division is our C8. So the circle will move to the center 1, then center 2, then it will move to the center 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. When it comes to center 8, circle will come center 8, the P point again comes back to the original position. Okay, so this comes to the initial position. So what we have done, we have transferred the centers from the baseline, from the divisions from the baseline up to the center line. We have marked as a center C1, C2, C3, C4. This is C3, this is C3, C4, C5, C6, 7 and 8. Okay, now once this is done, now the next is the last step. So what you have to do, you have to take the radius distance in compass. Take the radius distance in compass. Now, place it on C1. Take the center C1. Radius distance in compass. The center is C1. Cut the line passing through 1. Because we are on center 1. So you cut the line passing through 1. So what is the line passing through 1? So this is the line passing through 1. So you cut the line passing through 1. So you have to cut this line here. So you will get here intersection like this. So this is the 1. So what we have done, see here. So we got here point, center 1, you have to cut the line passing through 1. Now then next is you have to put your the compass on the center. You have to put your compass on center 2. Center 2, you have to cut the line passing through 2. What is the line passing through 2? This is the line passing through 2. Because I am on the center C2, so you have to cut the line passing through 2. So here it will come, the intersection. So this is 2 here. Okay, then go to the center 3. Now center 3, same radius distance in compass. We have to cut the line passing through 3. So we have to cut the line passing through 3. So this is the line passing through 3. So you have to cut it here. So this is C. We have cut the third point. Then next you take center C4. We have to cut a line passing through 4. So this is the line passing through 4. So it will come at the top only. So if you see here, this point will come up to here only. Okay. So this will come at the top because the point is same here. Okay. The point P will come now here. Okay, point comes here, 1, 2, 3 and then comes here. Then next you take center C5. Now what is the line passing through 5? So this is the line passing through 5. You see here, this is the line for 3 and 5. So we have to cut the line passing through 5. So this is the same line. So you cut this line here. So here, this is the, I have cut the line passing through 5. Then you take it on the center 6. What is the line passing through 6? See, this is the 6 line. This is the 6. Here, 6 is there. And this is the line passing through 6. So you have to cut the 6 line. So you have to cut it here. So you'll get this point. Then you go for 7. What is the line passing through 7? So this is the line passing through 7. This is 7 is here. So this is the line passing through 7. So you cut the 7 line. So it will come somewhat here. And the last point is C8. What is the line passing through 8? So this is our 8. After 7, we have this 8. So P point. So that comes here at you will get this becomes the radius only. Okay, this becomes your radius only. So this the last point will come here only. See here it comes on the here. Okay, last point. Okay. So what we have done? You see this one. See. I have taken radius distance in compass, C1 center. I have cut the line passing through 1. So 1, this is my first point. Okay. Then I have taken C2 center. I have cut the line passing through 2. So I got here the second point. Okay, here. Then C3 radius. I have cut the line passing through 3. So this is the third point. Then C4, I have cut the line passing through 4. So this is the fourth point. Then C5 center. I have cut the line passing through 5. So this is the intersection on fifth line. Then C6. So this is the sixth line. So we'll get the intersection here. Then C7. This is the 7th line. So you'll get the intersection somewhat here, nearer to A, this one. And last is what? Center C8. you will get the intersection on, this is 8 now, after 7, this P point is what? This is P or this is 8. So you will get the intersection here. Okay. So see how we have rotated, or we have cut the lines. So center C1 means one line, center C2 means you have to cut the second line, C3 means you have to cut the third line, C4 means you have to cut the fourth line, C5 means you have to cut the fifth line, C6 means you have to cut the sixth line, C7 means you have to cut the seventh line, and C8 means you have to cut the eighth line. Okay, so that is the baseline. Now you got your number of points now here. So P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, and P7 and P8. Okay, so now you have to join all these points. So how you join this point? So you have to use here, you have to use French curve again here, and you have to join all these points using the French curve like this. Okay, so you have to join all these points using the French curve like this. Okay, now whatever the curve we will get here, this here, so this is our cycloid. This is our cycloid. Okay, so this is the procedure for getting the cycloid. Okay, so this method you have to follow while construction of the cycloid. Okay, so now the cycloid is over. So let us go for the next now. So this already we have done, division of 7 and 8 parts. So here the same procedure, see here. So what we have done, we have taken the circle. Okay, now here this is the diameter is 50, so radius is 25. Okay, I have constructed the circle, I have divided that into do 8 parts, I have taken here 45 degree angle. Okay, then we have to take the baseline. What is the length of this baseline? That is equal to pi d distance, 3.14 into 50, because here diameter is 50. So 157 mm is what? It is 15.7 centimeter. So 15.7 centimeter you have to take. Circle is divided into 8 parts, so you have to divide the baseline also into 8 parts. Okay. After dividing the baseline into 8 parts, you transfer this one point on the center line C1. C2 goes on here, 3 goes on here, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. All the eight divisions you have to transfer on the center line. Then you have to draw the horizontal lines from 1, 7, 2 already there, from 3, 5, and 4. Now take radius distance in compass from C1, you have to cut one line. You have to cut one line. From C2, you have to cut second line. From C3, you have to cut third line. From C4, you have to cut fourth line. From C5, you have to cut fifth line. From C6, this is 6, so you have to cut this sixth line. From C7, you have to cut this seventh line. So this is 7th line. And from C8, the point will come here. And then using the French curve, you have to join all these points, so you will get the curve. So that is called as the cycloid. Now, if the point is here, if the point is on the ground, you will get this type of curve. You will get this type of curve. And if the point is away from the ground, say then see the point is P is here now. So we have started the nomenclature from here. There are two cases here. One case is the point P is here. So we have started nomenclature from here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now if the point is on the top, that is away from the ground, so here. So next point is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So if the point P is here, so then again you have to follow the same step. From C1, you have to cut one line. From C2, you have to cut second line. So if you cut 1, 2, 3, then now the fourth point comes here. It comes for here. Then from C5, then 5 fifth line. So this is the fifth line. C6, sixth line. C7, seventh line. And C8, eighth line. So if you take the point above the ground, okay, away from the ground, then the curve will become something like this. Okay. So you have to remember the shape of the curve. So when the curve is at the bottom, okay, when the P point is here, the curve will something like this, okay. And if the point is on the top, away from the ground, then the curve is something like this. So curve is something like this here, okay. So that you have to remember. Okay. So this is the construction of the cycloid. Then we have the next topic as the involute. Okay. The next topic is what, the involute. Now involute is also a single curve, like single curve line traced out by the end of the string when unwound itself from the circle. Okay, so imagine, suppose on the circle, okay, suppose we have the circle here, and on the circle you have wound the thread. इथे आपण थ्रेड अटॅच केला या सर्कलला. आता या सर्कलला काय करायचं, या थ्रेडला काय करायचं, या सर्कलवर वाउंड करायचं. वाउंड करायचं. सो व्हेन यू वाउंड दिस, दॅट मीन्स वाउंड दिस द थ्रेड ऑन दिस सर्कल, सो द डिस्टन्स ऑफ द थ्रेड विल डिक्रीज. ओके, and you will get one curve. So this curve is called as what? The involute. So this is that curve, we call this as a involute. Okay, so this is very simple. How we will get the involute? So involute means we consider the circle and attach one thread. So what is the length of this thread? So if you the length of the thread is equal to, again here, pi d distance, circumference of the circle. We'll take here the length of the thread is equal to circumference of the circle. Now wound this thread over the circle. सर्कल वर त्याला वाउंड करायचं. सो व्हेन यू वाउंड दिस द थ्रेड ओवर दिस सर्कल, सो यू विल गेट दिस कर्व. सो वी कॉल दिस कर्व एज अ इन्व्होल्यूट, अँड दिस इन्व्होल्यूट्स आर यूज इन द गिअर स्टील, इन द मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग ऑर इन द डिझाईन ऑफ द गिअर टीथ. ओके, सो नाऊ वी विल सी हाऊ टू कन्स्ट्रक्ट दिस इन्व्होल्यूट. वी विल सी हाऊ टू कन्स्ट्रक्ट दिस इन्व्होल्यूट नाऊ. सो अगेन लेट अस गो टू द आवर सॉफ्टवेअर देअर. ओके, सो आय एम टेकिंग हिअर. Now let us go for this one. Okay, so here again we have to first draw the circle. Okay, here we have to draw the circle. So how much distance radius we will take? So let us take again the same radius. We will take 1.5 as a radius. Okay, so I am taking here 1.5 radius. Okay, so this is 1.5 radius. Okay, so I have drawn the circle. Again, the same procedure. You draw the diameters for the circle. So this is one diameter, and we have to draw the vertical diameter also. Okay, here the vertical diameter. Okay, now divide this circle into 8 parts. Okay, so eight parts are sufficient to get the curve. So this is 0 here, this is 45, so this is 45 here, and from this side this is 0 and this is 45. So I have marked here 45, then I have to we will join these lines here. Okay, like this. So here this is first 45 degree line, and then it is on the other side. Okay, so like this. So your circle get divided into now 8 parts. Okay, circle get divided into the 8 parts now. Okay, so here now we will take again the same point. Suppose this is P point we will take here. Okay, we will take here the P point. Okay. Now, before giving the nomenclature, we will first draw the thread. We will first draw the thread. Now, we'll take the length of the thread. So, this is our circle and this is our thread. We'll take the length of this thread is equal to pi d. We'll take the length of this thread is equal to pi d. Now, here again, you will get the same distance, that is equal to 94.2. That is 9.42 centimeter. Pi d distance, so pi is 3.14. And d is equal to 30. So pi d distance comes out to be 94.2 mm, 9.42 centimeter. So length of the thread, so we will take here length of the thread is equal to, so this is 9.42. Okay, so this is 9.4. Okay, so in between 4 and 5, so this is 9.42. So this is our length of the thread. This is our length of the thread. Okay. Now we will how to give the nomenclature for involute. See, last time what we have done for the cycloid, we have taken point P here, and point P is rotating in this direction. It is rotating in this direction. So we have marked here 1, we have marked here 2, 3, 4, like this. Okay, clockwise we have marked the rotation. Now here if you see this thread, we will wound this direction. We will wound in this direction. Okay, that means in anti-clockwise direction. So in case of involutes, you have to give the nomenclature in the anti-clockwise direction. So this is 1, 2, 3, then this is 4, this is 5, this is 6 here, okay, this is 7, and the last point is our 8, this is our 8. So you have to remember this one, understand this one. In case of this cycloid, we have taken the nomenclature from this side because it is rotating in clockwise direction. Now here thread is, we are wounding the thread in anti-clockwise direction. This direction I am going from here to here, from right to left. I am going from right to left. So I have to give the nomenclature from here. Okay. So this will, this is 1. Okay. This is 2. This is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And last one is the 8. Okay. This is 6 here. Now I have divided the circle into 8 parts. So you have to divide this this thread also you have to divide this into 8 parts. So now let us divide this thread also into 8 parts. I have taken the inclined line at certain distance. Okay, now you take some small distance in compass. Okay, so I will reduce some distance. I am taking some distance in compass. Okay, so suppose I am taking this much distance in compass. Okay, now Marathi, how much divisions I want? 8. This one is the first, okay, then this is second, then this one is third, then this one is fourth, then this one is fourth, then this is five, then this one is six, then this one is seven, okay, and then the last one is here, this is eight, okay. This is 8 here. So I have to extend this line somewhat here. So this is 8 here. Okay. So this is 8. Okay. I got here 8. Now, what is the next procedure? So last divisions, you have to join with the end point of the line. Okay. So here, the last divisions, you have to join with the end point of the line. So this is 8 is joined with the end point of the line. Then from 7. Okay. This is 7. Then this is 6 here, then this is 5th division, then this is 4th division, okay, then this one is what, this is 4th, then this is 3rd division, okay, this one is the 2nd division, 2nd division, and this one is the 1st division, okay, this is the 1st division, okay, so similar to the cycloid, we have divided, so see these two steps are similar for cycloid and the cycloid and the involute. Only the difference is in the nomenclature. In cycloid, we have given the nomenclature in clockwise direction. In involute, we are giving the nomenclature in anti-clockwise direction. Okay. Now, I will name this one. So, this is 1. This is 1 for me. 1. This is 2. Then this is 3. Then this is 4 here. Okay. This is 5. This one is 6. This one is 7. Okay. And last one is the 8 division. Okay. So this is same for all the things, the cycloid and the involute. Okay, then now in involute, what we have to do, the next step is involute, we have to draw the tangents at the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So how to draw the tangent? See, when you keep your roller scale here, then the pointer on the scale must match with this line. See, I am matching this, the line of 2. with this radius. When you match the pointer on the scale with the radius, then you will get the perpendicular line. Then you will get here perpendicular line. Okay. So see, one tangent here like this. Okay. Now tangent from 1, then I have to draw the tangent from 2. So see, I have matched the line radius with the line. Then from this 2, so this is the second tangent from 2, okay, then the from the tangent from 3 now, okay, tangent from 3, so here like this, so this is the tangent from 3, okay, this is the tangent from 3, then we have to draw the tangent from 4, then we have to draw the tangent from 5, okay, we have to draw the tangent from here 5, so see I have matched here the pointer with the radius, So this is 5. Then we have to draw the tangent from 6. Okay, we have to draw the tangent from here, the 6, like this. Okay, 6 here. Then I have to draw the tangent from 7. From 7 here. Okay, so it will come something like this. Okay, you have to be very careful while drawing the tangents. You have to match this line on the scale with the radius. Then only you'll get the perfect perpendicular line here to the radius. Okay, so like this. So what we have done? See, so we have drawn the number. We have drawn the tangents at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. Now next is what? Now the next step is now to construct the involute. Now you take one. You take one and the 8 distance in compass. You take 1 and 8 distance in compass. For tangent 1, to mark the distance on tangent 1, you have to take 1/8 distance in compass. Okay, 1/8 distance in compass from 1 on the tangent 1. On the tangent 1, you have to mark this distance. You have to mark this distance. Which distance you have marked here? From 1 on the tangent 1, we have marked 1/8 distance. Okay, on tangent 2, we will mark here 2/8 distance. Now see, the length of the thread is reducing now. First is initially it is 1/8, now it is 2/8. Okay, now on the tangent 2, you have to mark this distance. Which distance we have marked here? 2/8. This distance is how much? This is 2/8 distance. And this on one tangent, we have marked 1/8 distance. Okay. Next is now on tangent 3, we have to mark 3/8 distance. Okay. We have to mark here 3/8 distance. Okay. We have to mark here 3/8 distance. So on tangent 3 here, we have to mark 3/8 distance. 3/8 distance. So this distance is how much? On tangent 3, we have marked 3/8 distance. Okay. Now on tangent 4, we have to mark 4/8 distance. Okay. We have to mark here 4/8 distance on tangent 4. Okay. So here, we have to mark here 4/8 distance. So this distance is how much? This is 4/8 distance. On tangent 4, 4/8 distance. Now on tangent 5, we have to mark 5/8 distance. 5/8 distance. On tangent 5, this is the tangent 5, we have to mark here 5/8 distance. Okay, so here we have to mark here 5/8 distance. Then this is our 5/8 distance we have marked. Then on the tangent 6, we have to mark 6/8 distance. We have to mark here the 6/8 distance on tangent 6. On tangent 6, we have to mark here 6/8 distance. 6/8 distance. So this is 6/8 distance. Here it is 6/8 distance we have marked. On tangent 7, last, that is our tangent 7, we have to mark here 7/8 distance. On tangent 7, we have to mark here 7/8 distance. So this is 7. On tangent 7, we have to mark here the 7/8 distance. Okay, like this. So this distance is how much? This is 7/8 distance. So now you see, the initial length of the thread is this one. Okay, so this is the initial length of the thread. Which one? P8. Then after that, when we wound this thread on the circle, now it get reduces by one division. That means now this P1 division get wound here. This P1 division get wound here. So how much thread is remaining? 1/8. So 1/8 we have marked here on 1/8. After that, when it goes to 2, how many divisions of thread get wounded? 1 and 2 divisions get wounded here. How much thread is remaining? 2/8 distance is remaining. So we have marked here 2/8. Then when you wound the thread on the circle up to 3, so this much division get wounded on the circle. This much division get wounded on the circle. So how much division is remaining? So 3/8 is remaining. So we have marked here 3a on 3 tangent. We have marked 3. So likewise, we have bounded the total thread on the circle, and after that, this 8 point. When you bound complete this thread, that is P28 thread. So the your point will come up to here. So P8 point will come here. Okay. So now after that, what we have to do? Now you have to join these all points like this. So this is P1. Okay. This is our P1 point. P comes up to here. Then this is P2 point. Okay. Then this is P3 point. This is P4 point. P5, P6, P7, and P8. Okay, like this. Okay. So it is very easy to draw this curve. What you have to do? You take P center 8 radius. You draw this arc. You will get here arc like this. Then you take you keep your compass here. You take this much radius. Okay. You take this much radius here, like this. This much radius. You draw the next arc like this. Sorry. You have to draw this arc here like this. You will get arc like this here. Here it will come like this. Then on from two, you will take this radius in compass like this. This radius, 2-8 radius in compass. From 2-8 distance in compass, and then draw the arc. You will get the arc something like this here. Okay, so let me see if it is coming or not. Okay, so it will come like this. Then next is what you'll do. You have to keep your compass here 3-8. You keep your compass, draw this arc. You will get this arc here. Then 4-8, you will draw this arc up to here. Then 5-8, you will draw the arc here. Then 6-8, you have to draw the arc here, and then 7-8, you will get the thread will come up to here. Okay. So likewise, you have to construct the curve. So how we have constructed the curve? First, we have drawn the circle. We have divided the circle into 8 parts. Nomenclature: it is we are wounding the thread in anticlockwise direction. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we have taken the thread. The distance of the thread is equal to pi d. Okay, so pi multiplied by 30. Diameter is 30, so that is equal to 9.42. We have divided the thread into 8 parts using the line division method. Then we have drawn the tangent at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, we have drawn the tangent. On tangent 1, which distance will come on tangent 1? 1 to 8. On tangent 1, 1 to 8, you have to take 1 to 8 distance. You have to mark it here. On tangent 2, you have to mark 2-8 distance. From 2 to 8 distance, you have to mark. On tangent 3, you have to mark 3-8 distance. On tangent 4, you have to mark 4-8 distance. Okay. On tangent 5, you have to mark 5-8 distance. On tangent 6, you have to mark 6-8 distance. And on tangent 7, you have to mark 7-8 distance. So here, like this. And then using this French curve, or you directly take the first radius is P8, you draw this arc. P8, you draw this arc. Then 1, 8, that is this intersection, 1 and this intersection, P1 point, you draw the second arc. Okay, you will get second arc here. This is our P2 point. Then 2, P2 distance, you draw the third arc. Okay, then you will get here P3 point. Then 3, P3 distance in compass, you draw the arc, you will get here P4 point. Then 4, P4 distance in compass, you will get the intersection here, this is P5. Then 5, P5 distance in compass, you will get P6 here. And 6, P6 distance in compass, you will intersect here. So this is your P7 point. And lastly, the point comes here. Okay, it comes here. Okay, so whatever the curve we have drawn, so this is curve is what? This is our involute. Okay, so this is the procedure for constructing the involute. Now, if you see here on our PPT also, so it is also given, see, circle is divided into 8 parts. The thread I have taken, that is here diameter is 50, so that's why the distance is 15.7. I have divided the thread into 8 parts using the line division method. Then you take tangents at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now on tangent 1, you mark 1-8 distance. Okay. Or this is, I have marked here P point. So I have taken marking here 1P distance. On tangent 2, 2P distance. On tangent 3, 3P distance. On tangent 4, 4P distance. On tangent 5, 5P distance. On tangent 6, 6P distance. And on tangent 7, 7P distance. And then join all these points, okay, you will get your involute. okay. So this curve, okay, so this curve you will get by taking the this as a red, this as a center, this center P radius, up to P radius you will get this arc. This arc you will get one center and this much radius, you will get this arc. Okay, now this arc you will get two center and this much radius, you will get this arc. Three center and this much radius, you will get this arc. Four center, this much radius, you will get this arc. Five center, this much radius, you will get this arc. Six and this much radius, you will get this arc. Okay, and lastly seven and this radius, you will get the last arc. So this becomes your involute. Okay, so this is the procedure for construction of the involutes and the involutes and the cycloids. Okay, so any difficulty in this construction, so you can ask. Otherwise, we will stop for the day. So thank you very much. Okay.